Hey guys, in my earlier video, what I have explained how can we write vanity URLs and how can we use a Sling resource resolver configuration factory. So just for that mapping purpose, I will just rephrase. So what we had done so far, we have written this mapping over here, content vwritle usn to nothing and content dam vwritle un to nothing, as in we just want to replace it with nothing. So that we can access the URLs like this. Now in this video, what I'm going to talk about, if your page is referencing maybe another image or another assets, how can we put our own custom links over here? Maybe it's a CDN URL or a dynamic media configuration URL, or maybe you just want to remove it again if it is not being removed with that configuration. How can we do that? Okay. So very first thing is what we have to do. We just have to open, I'll just open my CRXT. Okay, and inside apps, your folder means your project folder, there you need to create a config folder. Okay, the type is empty folder only. You have to write a rewriter. This is again a Sling folder. Okay, and then inside you have to create a node. Now in this node, if we have some few properties, I'll just put a package over in the video description. You can find the package. I will just upload it in Git so that you can reference it. And then here we have to specify the path, as in on which path we need this rewriter should work. Okay, so for example, I just given content vwritle usn. Okay, it will be HTML parser, and then transformer type is link rewriter. Okay, it can be link checker, or there in ACS Commons we have version client libs also available, but in this video I'm just going to talk about link rewriter. Okay, so as soon as this configuration is available on your project level, and basically it's a rewriter, and the transformer type is link rewriter. Now I'm going to go the code where I have written a custom link rewriter. Yes. So just a minute. Yeah, here it is. So what I'm saying is, my type is link writer, pipeline.type is link rewriter. So, and it's just implementing transformer factory. So since it's enabled, it will traverse whenever you refresh the page, it will traverse your page. And basically I have created a transformer. So if you go to this transformer, what's inside? So there are, if you implement this transformer, there are multiple methods that you have to implement. Since it's an interface, but the logic what I have written is, I'm just trying to get the attribute which is href. In our case, it's href. Just a minute. It's an href attribute, and whenever we find this href attribute, I'm just trying to find if it is this one or this one. If it is this one or this one, I'm just replacing it with the blank. Blank means I'm just trying to remove this content dam vwritle en. So just people women 6.jpg will come. Okay, we can also do that. So for example, if you want to return a CDN URL, so I will just return it https mycdn.com, and then it will append it. Okay. So that we can do, but I'm just not doing it. Okay. And then after this, we have to deploy this code. So in this code, I'm just replacing this value, as in whatever I have in href, I'm just replacing it with, if I find this string, I'm just replacing it with blank. Let me just deploy this code. It will be quick, just few more seconds. Yeah, let's install it. After we install it, let's just make sure it's enabled. It's not enabled. Let me just enable it. Now, right now it's the href is appended with content env and retail SEN. Let me just duplicate this page. And if we see it now, yeah, so it's removed now. Okay, we could have even added CDN URL. Let me just do that. So it's a damn URL, yeah. So what I will do, I will just add https mycdn.com. Save it. So this is better way, because at one time you have to write this transformer irrespective how many links or you page references are there, it will replace everywhere. Otherwise, for each URL, for example, if you have written any sling model, you have to rewrite it again and again. Just a few more seconds, it's done. Let's refresh this page again. So here we go. Okay, that's it in this video. I will add the code snippet as a Git repository URL in the video description. Thank you so much for watching.